think we both kind of went at it the same way, with just, you know, sort of assembling a dream team of people, asking people who, you know, that you thought would really be able to do it justice.
We brought in Steve Eisenstadt to play bass, and Steve is just the, he does his homework. The guy came in immediately and just knew everything. I think he even knew how to play this every song about three different ways, depending on who the bass player was. It was just stunning.
Some of these songs, from a bass player's perspective, are playgrounds. They are wonderful to play as a bass player because they're kind of driven by the bass, and are very creative, and you can do some interesting, very upfront things. So I think Hear Me Lord would be in that category, which the bass is making that song really kind of happen from a foundational perspective, and is a blast to play.
Give me Lord, please don't. I teach guitar, and every time I teach a Beatles song, I'm constantly going, oh my God, this song is genius.
You know, Bryon Settle, Pressure Boys, I mean, I remember seeing them, and I think I was just starting guitar then. I mean, maybe I just bought a guitar to be working with Bryon.
Learning these songs, they're completely different from Beatles songs in so many ways, especially timing. Wise, you know.
George Harrison has some really unusual ideas about harmony and constructing tunes.
I think it's a showcase for how great George Harrison was. A lot of those songs could not get on Beatles records.
He had all these songs when he only had one or two songs on every album. I think that was just a big wake-up call to say that, you know, this guy had a lot to do with the Beatles as well.
Why was it when I was younger were the John Lennon and Paul McCartney solo records the ones that I would instantly buy? I mean, when so much of a lesser album like Paul McCartney's Ram would come out, I'd buy it the first day. You know, a nice album. But nothing on the level of All Things Must Pass.
Don't care, but I do.